Here are the four things you need to do right now to make sure your pet is ready. Make sure your pet is microchipped. Make reservations at a pet shelter or your vet in case you do have to leave and you can't take your pet with you. You should also always have extra food and medication on hand and be sure that you have a pet carrier, a crate. Well, with technology the way it is these days, it's almost as if our phones are an extension of ourselves.
Exactly. So how do you stay connected with this lifeline when the power will most likely go out? Here are some things you can do that will help save your battery life. The first is to close location services. You can do that through your phone setting.
Second, turn off Bluetooth. It's something you won't need as you ride out a storm.
Because you're at home.
Yes.
And third, lower the screen brightness. Brightness is one of the top features that can actually drain your battery.
Fourth, keep Wi-Fi on and use MiFi if necessary.
Finally, make sure your laptop is fully charged, and when the power does go out, use it for the sole purpose of charging your phone.
And as Sandra Shaw shows us, one other option is to get a portable generator to keep the juice going during massive outages.
But you've got to make sure it's maintained.
So it does you absolutely no good to have a generator if it's not primed and ready for use. First things first, safety. Make sure it's a good distance from the house, especially things like the garage, doors, and windows. Number two, make sure you have plenty of fuel. First thing you want to do is make sure you add a stabilizer to it so it stays fresh. Then you want to fill up the generator with your fuel, and then after that, make sure you have enough extra fuel, at least 20 gallons. Next, check and change the oil 5 hours after the first use, and then after that, about once a year. You're also going to want to exercise it. Do a dry run. In other words, turn it on and turn the fuel valve off while it's still running. That can clear the carburetor and prevent leaks. And finally, especially before the start of hurricane season and throughout the season, give it a workout. Run it normally for about 20 minutes once a month.
And we do want to go back to that Wi-Fi because we know that Xfinity is offering thousands of hotspots free to people during the storm right now also, so that you can stay connected to your family. You can go to Xfinity.com to figure out exactly the closest hotspot.
Well, staying connected to other people, not just phones and electricity, is important as well.
Make sure you have a storm buddy, a neighbor, somebody close to you to check in on you during the storm and also in the aftermath of a storm.
Also, having a whistle is actually a good idea. If you happen to get trapped, you can alert rescuers to where you are.
And we have partnered with Coast 101.3 as well as True Oldies 95.9 and 106.9 to keep you updated with forecasts when the storm threatens South Florida. If a storm does hit and you aren't near your television or you lose power, you can listen to our live broadcast on the radio.
The WPBF 25 News app is also a great tool to keep you up to date with the latest headlines, but we also have a free app dedicated just to hurricane coverage. We'll be right back.